I wonder sometimes who I am. When the Committee on Lectures of Drama announced my lecture in the newspapers, someone was afraid the readers might not know who I am. So they informed them as follows. A famous theoretician and controversial musical figure known for the influence he has brought to bear on modern music. Up to now, I thought I composed for different reasons. May I hope in another 50 years they will also know who I am. Of 75 years of my life, I have devoted almost 90% to music. I had begun violin at the age of 8 and almost immediately I had started composing. All my compositions to about my 17th year were nothing more than imitations of such music as I could become acquainted with, since my only sources had been violin duets and duet arrangements of operas on the one hand and the repertory of military bands which played in public bar on the other hand. One must not forget that at this time printed music was extremely expensive. There were not yet records nor radios and that Vienna had only one opera theater and one cycle of 8 philharmonic concerts a year. Only when I met 3 young men of about my age and that obtained their friendship, my musical and literary education started. First, Oscar Adler, whose talent as a musician was as great as his capacities in science. Through him I learned that there exists a theory of music and he directed my first steps therein. My second friend was David Bach, a linguist, philosopher, connoisseur of literature and a mathematician. The third friend is the one to whom I owe most of my knowledge of the technique and the problems of composing, Alexander von Zemlinsky. I had been a Brahmsian when I met him. His love embraced both Brahms and Wagner. And soon thereafter, I was an addict of the same color. No wonder that the music composed at that time mirrored the influence of both these masters, to which a flavor of Liszt, Bruckner and perhaps of Hugo Wolf was added.
Das ist meine Situation. Ich befinde mich in einer Minderheit, nicht nur gegenüber den Freunden leichter Musik, sondern auch gegenüber den Freunden ernster Musik. Niemandem fällt es ein, die Helden anzufeinden, die den Flug über den Ozean oder zum Nordpol wagen. Denn ihre Leistung wird rasch jedem offenbar. Aber obwohl die Erfahrung gezeigt hat, dass viele längst schon Pfadfinder auf einem klar bewussten Weg waren, als man sie noch für halb irrsinnige Wegsucher hielt, so wendet sich doch die Feindschaft der Mehrheit stets gegen die, die auf geistigem Gebiet ins Unbekannte vorstoßen. Neue Musik ist niemals von allem Anfang an schön. Sie wissen, dass nicht nur Mozart, Beethoven und Wagner mit ihren Werken anfangs auf Widerstand stießen, sondern dass auch Verdis Rigoletto, Puccinis Butterfly und sogar Rossinis Barbier von Sevilla ausgepfiffen wurden und dass Carmen durchgefallen ist.
It has happened in the last years that I have been questioned whether certain of my compositions are pure 12th tone or 12th tone at all. In fact, I do not know all this. I am still more a composer than a theorist, and when I compose, I try to forget all theories, and I continue composing only after having freed my mind. It seems to me urgent to warn my friends of orthodoxy. Composing with 12 tones is only in a rather small way a forbidding and excluding method. It is in first respect a method ascertaining logical order and organization, of which comprehensibility should be the main result.
Unterschätzen Sie nicht die Größe des Kreises, der sich um mich bildet. Er wird wachsen durch die Wissbegierde einer idealistischen Jugend, die sich mehr durch das Geheimnisvolle angezogen fühlt, als durch das Alltägliche. Nehmen Sie das, meine Herren, nicht für Hochmut. Ich hätte gerne besseren Erfolg. Es ist keineswegs mein Wunsch, als einsamer Seilenheiliger darzustellen. Wem unser Herrgott die Bestimmung gegeben hat, Unpopuläres zu sagen, dem hat er die Fähigkeit verliehen, sich damit abzufinden, dass es immer die anderen sind, die verstanden werden.
I was a painter, perhaps, but I am not any longer a painter. I didn't paint for many, many years. I tell you what painting meant to me. In fact, it was to me the same as making music. It was to me a way of expressing myself, of presenting emotions, ideas, and other feelings. And this is perhaps the way to understand these paintings, or not to understand them. As a painter, I was absolutely an amateur and had no theoretical training and only little aesthetic training, and this only from general education. In music it was different. So I was also an autodidact. I always had the opportunity to study the works of the masters and to study them in quite a professional manner, so that my technical ability grew in a normal manner. This is the difference between my painting and my music.